Life is in his hands. Listen. I know he will.
And if your heart is broken,
this is all you have to do.
Just lift your hands.
Oh, come on and worship with me. Say it. Come on.
Oh, I know that I can make it.
Don't you give up. I know.
I know that I can stand.
Hang on. Joy is coming. I know
no
it is.
No matter what you may come my way.
Jesus, my life. Hallelujah, hallelujah. With him, I know I can take it.
Jesus, I
thank you, Jesus. With him, I know.
With him, I know.
I feel like having some church in here. No matter
no
what,
matter what you
Yeah. Jesus, my life is in.
My life is in your
every person that's going through, lift your hands and say it with me. I know I can.
I know that I can.
I got a witness in here somewhere. I know. Hallelujah. No matter what may come my way.
No matter what
hallelujah
may come my way.
Jesus, my life is in.
My life is in.
Oh, I love you so much, Jesus. With you, I know I can.
Jesus, I can take
you. Oh, bless your name, Jesus.
With him, I know I can.
No matter what may come. No matter what you're going through, I know that you can stand. For your life is in his hands. Listen.
Troubles, they don't last always. For there's a friend in Jesus.
No matter what you're going through, I know that you can stand. For your life is in his hands.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. No matter matter what you're going through. His grace and mercy do it for him. He loves you. I know he does. No matter what you're going through, I know that you can stand, for your life is in his hands. Listen.
Come on, let's head with me. I know
that I can make it.
I know you can make it. I know you can. No matter what may come my way, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Yes, with him, I know I can take it.
Oh, glory, glory.
I feel him all in my spirit right now. I feel him.
Thank you, Jesus.
No matter what may come my way.
Lord,
thank you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. No matter what you're going through, his grace and mercy do it for him. He loves you. I know he does. No matter what you're going through, I know that you can stand, for your life is in his hands. Listen. I know he will.
And if your heart is broken,
this is all you have to do.
Just lift your hands.
Oh, come on and worship with me. Say it. Come on.
Oh, I know that I can stand.
Don't you give up. I know.
I know that I can stand.
Hang on. Joy is coming. I know
no
it is.
No matter what you may come my way.
Jesus, my life. Hallelujah, hallelujah. With him, I know I can take it.
Jesus,
I thank you, Jesus. With him, I know.
With him, I know.
I feel like having some church in here. No matter
what,
come on. Yeah. Jesus, my life is in. Every person that's going through, lift your hands and say it with me. I know I can.
I know that I can take it.
I got a witness in here somewhere. I know. Hallelujah. No matter what may come my way.
No matter what
Hallelujah.
May come my way.
Jesus, my life is in.
My life is in.
Oh, I love you so much, Jesus. With you, I know I can.
Jesus, I can take
you. Oh, bless your name, Jesus.
With him, I know I can.
No matter what may come my way.
No matter what
Hallelujah.
May come my way.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on and say it with me. I know.
I know that I can make it.
I know you can make it. I know you can.
I know that I
no matter what may come my way. Thank you, Jesus.
No matter what
Hallelujah.
May come my way.
Yes. Hey, with him, I know I can take it.
Jesus,
oh, Lord, Lord, Lord. I feel it all in my spirit right now. I feel it. Thank you, Jesus. No matter what may come my way.
No matter what may come my way.
Oh, hallelujah.
My life is in your
Thank you, Jesus. No matter what you're going through.
My life is in your
His grace and mercy. Do it for him.
My life is in
He loves you. I know he does. No matter what you're going through, I know that you can stand, for your life is in His hand. I love him.
Who will wipe your tears away?
I know he will. And if
your heart is broken,
this is all you have to do.
Just lift your hands.
Oh, come on and worship with me. Say it. Come on.
Oh, I know that I can make it.
Don't you give up. I know.
I know that I can stand.
Hang on, joy is coming. I know
no
it is.
Matter
You're going through, I know that you can stand, for your life is in his hands. Listen. some church in here. No matter what may come. Yeah. Jesus, my life is in.
faith in Jesus Christ, we receive the body of our brother Wilfred Wilson for burial. Our brother was washed in holy baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Let us therefore with confidence pray to God our Heavenly Father, the giver of life, that he will raise him to perfection in the company of the saints. The Lord be with you and also with you. Let us pray. Console us who mourn. Give us faith to see in death the gate of eternal life, so that in quiet confidence we may continue our course in it, until by your call we are reunited with those who have gone before. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and I am the life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. Whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. Steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His compassion never fails. Every morning they are renewed. Jesus said, let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. I'm sure that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. If we live, we live to the Lord. If we die to the Lord. So that whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. For to the same Christ died and lived again, that he might be Lord both of the dead and of the living. He brought nothing into the world, and we shall take nothing out. The Lord gives, and the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The eternal God is our refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms. Amen. Is there a eulogy? Come, sir.
Good afternoon, everybody. Wilfred Wilson, son of Edmund and George Wilson, husband of Shirley, father of Stephon and Karen, brother of Ina, Janet, Roslyn, Marlene, and Michael. Uncle Wilfred will always be remembered. Somebody who has always been hardworking. I always remember him, especially when working at Trimmer. And you know, he would always be, people say, judging by his age. I say, what that woman could throw a rope boy onto the platform? And my colleague, my colleagues doubt him. I say, well, what's wrong? And he would never miss that ball on the platform, and never. Because why? Because he is always dedicated to whatever he do. Could be matter how small, right? All with his home, always ensure that all, everything is at home, it's right. No matter what, I already see that he is very particular about his house, very particular about his place, right? Always giving thanks for that. And you know what? The same thing he always tried to instill in Stephon. And you know that, when he was alive, no matter what he did, that what he always is, he always look hard. Right? And who if you always be remembered, you know, that just being here with Shirley. And you know, that is a shadow. Right? So that's why the whole that you know that we really have to give thanks also to Shirley. And you know, despite what she stood there with him in sickness, bedside, side by side with him. Right? She would not leave his side. And even if she leaves his side, she's always making sure that he is alright. Always making sure he is well taken care of. Always making sure he's fed. No matter what, that she's always been there for him. Right? He'll always be remembered, he'll always be dedicated to whatever he do. No matter what. And you know what, he will surely be missed. I say we have to give the Lord thanks for all they know that, for all the assistance also from all the friends and family. People like Marissa, people like my father Wayne, people like Sharon, and countless others also who stood there and assisted, right? Out here now that is so different to know that, you know, that to find genuine people to help you now is so hard also, because everybody have that selfish nature about them, and everybody about themselves. But they know what the Lord has been, especially the Lord. The Lord has never given up on us. So hence why he has always helped us to help our mission to heaven for one another. And additionally, the Lord will surely bless you. Stephon, the Lord will surely bless you also. I can tell you that, man. Surely bless you. I see your father's looking down in heaven right now, giving thanks and praise. I see Uncle Freddie not suffering no more. You're not suffering no more at all. You are truly remembered. Your man of BC will never deny that. Never deny that. Right? May God bless you. Bless you.
On the program, we'll sing the hymn, Enter into Jerusalem. Enter into Jerusalem, let us go to God's house, with the healthy and the sick, with the worker and the weak, let us go to God's house. Enter into Jerusalem, let us go to God's house, run good and win with the God who reigns in peace. Let us go to God's house, we go celebrate. We go celebrate. We go celebrate. O Israel, praise the name of the Lord on high. Praise his name in song. Praise the Lord. With a heavenly song, praise the Lord. Enter into Jerusalem, may we walk down there, with the young and the old, with the little and the large, may we walk down there. Enter into Jerusalem, may we walk down there, swaying to the breeze, with the God who reigns in peace. May we walk down there, we go celebrate. We go celebrate. We go celebrate. O Israel, praise the name of the Lord on high. Praise his name in song. Praise the Lord. With a heavenly song, praise the Lord. Enter into Jerusalem, let us go to God's house, with your papa and your mama, with your uncle and your aunt, let us go to God's house. Enter into Jerusalem, let us go to God's house, run with the breeze to the God who reigns in peace. Let us go to God's house, we go celebrate. We go celebrate. We go celebrate. O Israel, praise the name of the Lord on high. Praise his name in song. Praise the Lord, enter heaven, please song. With a heavenly song, with a heavenly song, praise the Lord. In the midst of life, we are in debt. From whom can we seek help? For you alone, O Lord, by our sins are just the younger. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one, have mercy upon us. Lord, you know the secret of our hearts. Shut not your ears to our prayers. But spare us, O Lord, holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one, have mercy upon us. O worthy and eternal judge, do not let the pains of death turn us away from you at our last hour. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one, have mercy upon us. Let us pray. Almighty God, remember before you today your servant Wilfred. We pray that having opened to him the gates of larger life, you'll receive him more and more into your joyful service. And with all who have faithfully served you in the past, he may share in the eternal victory of Jesus Christ, O Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. We now have the first scripture reading, Ecclesiastes 3:1-8, and I'm asking someone in the congregation to please come up and do it. For everything there is a season, and a time for every matter under heaven. A time to be born, and a time to die. A time to plant, and a time to pluck up what is planted. A time to kill, and a time to heal. A time to break down, and a time to build up. A time to weep, and a time to laugh. A time to mourn, and a time to dance. A time to throw away stones, and a time to gather stones together. A time to embrace, and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to seek, and a time to lose. A time to keep up, and a time to throw away. A time to tear, and a time to sow. A time to keep silence, and a time to speak. A time to love, and a time to heal. A time of war, and a time of peace. Psalm 23 is not printed on the program, but I'll sing it to Primon. Those of you might know it. Very familiar version that is used at funeral services and services accordingly. The Lord's my shepherd, I'll not want. He makes me in presence of my foes, my head thou dost with oil anoint, and my cup overflows. Goodness and mercy all my life shall surely follow me, and in God's house forevermore my dwelling place shall be. Next reading is taken from the Gospel of John, chapter 11. I'm reading verses 21 to 27. Martha said to Jesus, "Lord, if you had been here, my my brother would not have died. But even now I know that God will give you whatever you ask of him. Jesus said to her, your brother will rise again. Martha said to him, I know that he will rise again in the resurrection and the last day. Jesus said to her, I am the resurrection and I am the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this? She said to him, yes, Lord, I believe that you are the Messiah, the Son of God, the one coming into the world. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Before the message this evening, we shall sing on the program, Because He Lives. God sent His Son, they call Him Jesus. He came to love, heal and forgive. He lives and died to buy my pardon. An empty grave is there to prove my Savior lives. Because He lives, I can face tomorrow. Because He lives, all fear is gone. Because I know He holds the future, and life is worth the living just because He lives. How sweet to hold a newborn baby and feel the pride and joy He gives. But greater still, the calm assurance, this child can face and certain days, because He lives. Because He lives, I can face tomorrow. Because He lives, all fear is gone. Because I know He holds the future, and life is worth the living just because He lives. And then one day, I'll cross the river, I'll fight life's fight, no war within. And then as death gives way to victory, I'll see the light of glory and I'll know He lives. Because He lives, because He lives, I can face tomorrow. Because He lives, all fear is gone. Because I know He holds the future, and life is worth the living just because He lives. My reflection this afternoon comes from words that Paul wrote to the people in Rome, the book called Romans, the 8th chapter, the 38th to the 39th verse. I am sure that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. Friends gathered, I speak in the name of God, the Father, Jesus, the risen Son, and the guiding Holy Spirit. Amen. First, let me, on behalf of the parish where I serve as priest, St. Mark Parish, some would know it as St. Mark Anglican Church, Point 14, express deepest condolences to the relatives, friends, loved ones, all concerned for deceased brother Wilfred Wilson, whom God called out of this world on the 20th day of April 2022, praying that Almighty God in His loving mercy, when His Son Christ Jesus comes to be the judge of all mankind on the resurrection or judgment day, He'd find a place worthy to send our brother Wilfred to be with God, Jesus, angels, and all who entered here. For those of you who have the program, as you can see, my name is Father Harold Dickerson, Parish Priest of St. Mark, Anglican Point 40. Whenever you hear these words, friends gathered, I am sure it tells you something. That whoever is speaking with some form of certainty and assurance or conviction that something is happening, is about to happen, or will take place in the future. And Paul set it out for us in the book of Romans, 8th chapter, 38 to the 39th verse. I am sure that neither death nor life, angels, principalities, powers, things present, things to come, height, depth, anything else in all creation will ever be able to separate Wilfred Wilson from the love of God in Christ Jesus, our Lord. I want to say as I continue, death is something that will come to every one of us. The strange thing about it, if you want to say it like that, is this. Nobody knows what kind of death will come to them. However, it is important, my people of God gathered, that daily in our lives, as our eyes are open, we say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, for sparing our lives to see another day in this vineyard. To which I'm sure all of us did today, the 27th day of April 2022. Because as I said before, only, I should say it like this now, only who was not born will not die. That's a fact. And since none of us know when our time and passing will come, it is important that we understand importantly how Jesus plays that major role in our lives every day. Not only have we received the bread of life bestowed upon us today, but we continue to receive daily the meals, breakfast, lunch, dinner. Children are now going back to school. People who have work to go to go and do their work. We have also been provided with a vehicle to bring us to this funeral service this afternoon. All because of Jesus being present every day in our lives and making everything a possibility and reality for us. As I look at the program, I see Wilfred was born on the 5th day of December 1951. And God called him out of this world on the 20th day of April 2022. 49 and 22 makes 71. In fact, he was almost 71, because if he had lived to the 5th of December, he would have been 71, am I right? Good. So what are we learning here as well? Not forgetting. Remind me. Scripture says, what is the lifespan of a man or woman? T-score 10. 70. So, our brother lived out the lifespan of a man or woman. And he was about to enter as
The scripture also says in good health up to 80, but he just went a little more than the 70. God knows why it had to be so. And I want to always say as well, God gives life and he takes it in his time. Stephen read the reading. A time to be born and a time to die. And that is what actually happened with our brother Wilfred Wilson, 20th April 2022. But I want to say this as well, as I continue. If you don't, and I've got to realize it, listen, people, the next second is not in our hands. I, Father Dickerson, preaching, saying farewell to Wilfred Wilson this afternoon. But if God says that is the last time I will be here, nobody could do anything about it. He gives life, takes it in his time, not in our time. That is why, as we continue our journey and course on earth, we need to make it our business to have true love in our hearts.
Amen. Yes.
Now let me explain what is true love. We have just kind of way, I say kind of way, understand what I'm saying. We have just kind of way come out of the pandemic, country open back and so forth and so forth and so forth. I don't know what I'm talking about.
Yes.
But country open back, well, let's say we still wearing masks. Do you know what I mean to say? We still have to follow protocols.
Yes.
Sanitizing, social distance, and all the other things now. Right? We only, well, you know, know it already. I tell already. But I want to say this as well. We must understand, over the 2 year period of the pandemic, we were hearing all kind of things about vaccine and all of that. The priest can't tell about vaccine when I take it on, none of my business. But what I want to say is this. A vaccine is better than injecting a needle. But why I'm saying that is this. Inject yourself with love.
Amen.
Inject your heart with love.
Amen.
You know who you know if your heart have love? Psalm 51:11. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within.
Amen.
You know what it is? What create mean? Make. So what is the psalmist say? Make in me a clean heart. What is a clean heart? Well, everybody should say a clean heart is a clean heart. Opposite of clean is dirty. So what does the scripture say? Your heart must be clean and a right spirit from God will be renewed within you.
Amen.
As I look at these two sisters here, the portion of scripture I want to bring in here now is what I read in the gospel. Martha having the discussion with Jesus. Their brother Lazarus was dead, buried in the tomb for 4 days. And the discussion went on. And Jesus said, your brother will rise to life in the resurrection on the last day. Do you believe this? She said, yes, Lord, I believe you are the Messiah, the Son of God coming into the world. And my people, I want to say something this evening again as I continue. Jesus did something to show his humility, his love, his compassion for every human being. He said to Martha and Mary, take me. Take me to the tomb where your brother Lazarus has now been placed for 4 days. And what did he do there? He wept, cried. And people will say, why Jesus cried? Because he is always a human being. Every one of us is born as a human being. So no matter what, they call him Son of God and Messiah and all of that. He is a human being. So he showed his human form and then he said, Lazarus, come out of the grave. What did he do there? He removed tears from Martha and Mary's eyes. And Jesus just called his sister there. Thank you. Remove the tears from Martha and Mary's eyes, putting a new breath of life back into Lazarus, performing the miracle of the resurrection. My people, we are in the resurrection season, you know.
Yeah.
Easter Sunday was the 17th of April. Sunday gone was the second Sunday of Easter. And what did God do? He put a new breath of life back into Jesus after he was placed in the tomb, having been crucified for the people's sins on earth on the first Good Friday. He put a new breath of life so his heart continued and began to work again. And that is what we are praying will happen to Wilfred Wilson. A new breath of life will be put back into him on the resurrection or judgment day that will come. A day that you do not know, I do not know, but God knows and Jesus knows when it will come.
Amen.
I also want to say this afternoon to all family members and all gathered, friends and so forth, when you feel the cry, cry.
Amen.
Because crying will tell this guy who I'm looking at, and looking at me too, or any other small thing, Wilfred Wilson will understand why you're crying. Right, sisters?
Yes.
So don't hold back. I call her less sister, a small thing, right? Good. He will understand. Because I heard the guy who came up and read the eulogy said he was dedicated and devoted to what he was doing.
Amen.
Now, when I hear that, you know what I want to say as well? Not everybody who do work today dedicated and devoted, you know, they're lazy. Productivity low. So when I could hear Wilfred Wilson was dedicated, oh Lord, I want plenty more Wilfred Wilson in this world today. Conscious slash world. Let me give my life a second, I'm going to carry me nothing. Right now, I'm saying it as it is. Facebook or wherever I'm on. Listen to this. CPEP, I hope you don't know CPEP people here. But anyhow, I want to cash you for any case. Right? They come by me where I live in Faisabad. 7 o'clock, they start to work and they leave 8 o'clock. Now they tell me what productivity is that. All right, let me not go for the car. I'll go off. Let me leave it there. Wilfred Wilson would not have done that. He would have put in his 8 hours. End of his 8 hours?
Yeah,
lunch hour that, right? Well, how much, right? You sound, well, you look sound like you sound right. Use the sound. Right. But I want to say this as well. For the family, it is even more challenging because of what type of death he faced, or what type of death happened to him, if you want to call it that. Pandemic, right? Pandemic. And only see what pandemic do, and only heard what Adana said, right? Casket stay closed, and then all you hear are the pictures of photos and so forth. That is not easy for the family to understand now. But I just saw pandemic working. But I pray with you, and you pray with me, that this pandemic will go.
Amen.
Time for it to go.
Yes.
You can watch me. All you listen to me. I'm also a school teacher at the Point 49 against 22 and says, sir, sometimes we see the mask off your face and say, I don't want to die with no COVID because I can't breathe properly. So I take a little second or so, but I hold it hard because I know there's somebody on the Facebook taping every time when people say the priest doing service and they don't carry a mask on his face. Tell him as it is. Serious thing. It's not easy to keep on this mask. But God is good. And his mercy will and shall endure forever and ever. And I put in this piece. I have to put in this piece. Can't be nothing again. His father, because there's only one father, because he doesn't have to have no more. Small thing. Anyhow. Hear this. You know, I realize 20 people in some instances very deceitfully.
Yes.
Let me tell you what I mean.
Yes.
What month here? April?
Yes.
What we had on February 14th? Valentine's Day?
Yes.
Valentine's Day as a currency. I play fast with my fast self, yes. I leave the church in point, going home, Faizabad, as I said, I reside. So I stop in on the road to ask them people, how much should them teddy bear? 500, 800, 1,000. See, yeah, you see all them know? Because they get some. Anyhow. Hear this. I have no problem with a man liking a woman, boyfriend, girlfriend thing now, you know, all the one know I mean now. Giving her the teddy bear on Valentine's Day. Like 14th, right? For the 15th, she and he getting a little conflict and he slap she. Like deceitfulness. You can't love somebody 24 hours before and 24 hours after you hit them. Check yourself. And it's the same thing that's happened for Christmas Day too, right?
Yeah.
People, what is second greatest commandment say? Love your neighbor as you love yourself. Don't love your neighbor only on Valentine's Day and Christmas Day. You'll get punishment from God. I always say, if people lovey-lovey, people Valentine's Day and greedy-greedy and going to people's house Christmas Day, they should have Christmas Day and Valentine's Day every day. Because if we have Valentine's Day and Christmas Day every day, we don't have so much killing. Very old, we are good. I want to say something again. And I'll leave that, eh? Good, eh? I'll leave that. Hear this. Despite every lovely things we heard in the eulogy, nobody is perfect. Wilfred would have had his shortcomings. And I'm sure because of growing up in whatever church, about I mean, I don't know, he would have been able to say, God, I'm sorry for my mistake. Hey, you see this priest? He got sinned too. Plenty priests ain't gonna say that too. But this priest will say it. Because anytime I feel, and listen to me carefully, anytime I feel like perfect, I come out of the priest because I'm out of place. Totally out of place. That is why I just said it earlier. Jesus died for our sins on the cross so we can have life today and live it in abundance with God and everyone around us. Right? And, well, only, I'm still going to say this too. And Elita, boy. He has some people in this country. I see a nurse sitting there. World mask with a blue mask. I ain't about talking to your nurse. Good. But I have to use you to let, yes, as you know, the men will never tell me name. I want to know. So anyhow, here some people feel they're better than the nurse and the doctor, the best pathologists. Now pathologists, the nurse will help me, is the ones who does tell you where die from, right? Am I right, nurse? Right, don't forget check your head. I don't do nothing, but I know a small thing. Right. And it has some people, but it's not only here. They say don't put your hand on a block. I put my hand on a block. It's not only people here. He has some people, when they didn't hear somebody die, but 7 days, all right? 7 days, all right?
Yeah.
I wonder where he died from. Mind their business. And family, me and all the name, I don't know. Don't let nobody call all and ask all in our stupidness.
That's right,
amen. Yeah. Spend with us.
Oh, yeah.
People don't know the place.
Oh, yeah.
If anybody of them play fast, well, there's nothing people here. We're going to play fast. Right? Right, they fast, they will not come here. They're waiting to tell you that on the outside, on the phone, on the Facebook. So they're fast. Thank God they're not fast. Anyhow, hear this. Sisters, when all they leave here and all they carry, Wilfred and do the internment at Capitol Cemetery, and I'll go home and I'll relax him. Anybody call a little axle any shepherdess? Tell them this. Tell them Father Dickerson say this. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He makes me to lie down green pasture. Let them know the place.
Amen.
You better know the place.
Amen.
You have to know your place. Leave fastness or my native people business for 10 generations to come. When we're not here. We are business. We are here. We here now. And a little. Well, what am I saying? That's one thing. Right? Now, we have to also understand that the God we serve, as I said before, gives life tickets in time and so forth. But I want to show you one thing before we go, before we continue. Everyone have a program, right? Policy 5th December 51, right? Policy a dash. And only realize after the dash come 20th April 2022. Right. Every one of us know our date of birth, right? We have the dash there after our date of birth. Our departure day will be filled, which is sunset, when we die. So all of us will experience this. But I want to say this afternoon as well. I want to thank God for the time that he spared, the 70 and a bit years he spent, he allowed, sorry, we're trying to live on this earth. I want to thank God for the family for asking me to come and do the service. Nice small thing. The only realize the priest talking young people thing, right? Because the priest young. So that way you're talking young people thing, that small thing and all them thing now. You understand me? The priest is 52.8 years.
Yeah.
I tell the children out in school, they say, what do you mean by 52.8 years? 52 years, 8 months. That what I mean? God's grace, August 23rd, I turned 53. That's what I mean. Thank God for you, Sister Grace.
Yeah.
Grace is a favor bestowed from God.
Yeah, that's right.
This guy had grace until 20th April,
amen.
2022.
That's right.
And early done. But I have to say this as well before I finish. To the family again, be strong.
Yeah.
Thank you all for coming and supporting the family.
Amen.
Important. Keep supporting them. And my good partner is Stefan. That way he will ask me to be friend. That's one thing. Anyhow, you know my number. Call me anytime. Because show me that call me. I ain't gonna tell you nothing stupid. And if I tell you anything stupid, put me in my place because you remember what I said at your father's funeral. Simple. Right. Now sister, I didn't vex it here. The lady who answered the phone. I know Jesus was telling me the service going on. Small thing. Small thing. No, because I don't want to go vexing with me now. For next year, see me that I'm going to get a big son up with my hand. No, lady. Good. But I pray this afternoon as, well, this is the last thing I'm going to say now. I say that about 100 times already. Now, God's grace, God's blessing, God's love, God's mercy, God's protection will be with Wilfred Wilson as his body is interred in Captiville Cemetery to wait on the resurrection day to hear his name called, to be risen in glory, to go before Christ, to give an account. Jesus called somebody again there. Nice small thing, man. Jesus know what's going on, man. Where his, as he rises in glory, he will go before God, son Jesus, to give an account of the 70 and a bit years he lived on this earth. And he will hear these words, well done, my faithful servant, Wilfred. Go now into the place called heaven to be with God, Jesus, the angels, and all who entered here. Rest eternal grant unto our brother, Wilfred Wilson, O Lord. Let life perpetual shine upon him. May soul and all the faithfully departed, through the mercy of Almighty God, rest in peace and rise in glory. And the people of God all say, amen. Amen.
I done right? Sure, I'm not done.
sometimes this lady comes to tell me it's time for the service to done, but this lady here. Oh, anyhow. So we continue. I will now say the words of the Apostles' Creed and do an intercession before we sing a hymn, after which we'll have the commendation and committal of the body before we leave. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven, seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, Holy Catholic Church, communion of saints, forgiveness of sins, resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Almighty God, you have knit your chosen people together in one communion in the mystical body of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Give to your whole church in heaven and on earth your light and your peace. Hear us, Lord. May we, who have been baptized into Christ's death and resurrection, die to sin and rise to newness of life. May we with him pass through the grave and gate of death into the joyful resurrection. Hear us, Lord. Grant to us who are still on this pilgrimage and who walk as yet by faith, that by your Holy Spirit may lead us in holiness and righteousness all our days. Hear us, Lord. Grant to your faithful people pardon and peace, that they may be cleansed from all their sins. Serve you with a quiet mind. Hear us, Lord. Grant to this Wilson family a sure confidence in your loving care, that casting all their sorrows on you, they may know the consolation of your love. Hear us, Lord. Give courage and faith to those, especially the Wilson family, in bereavement, that they may have strength to meet the days to come in the comfort of a holy and certain hope, joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love. Hear us, Lord. Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to you our brother Wilfred, who was reborn by water and spirit in holy baptism. Grant that his death may recall to us the victory over death, be an occasion for us to renew our trust in your Father's love. Give us, we pray, the faith to follow where you have led the way, and where you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit to the ages of ages. Amen. Before the commendation and committal of the body, we shall sing on the program, What a Friend We Have in Jesus. Now, only realize the priest like to talk, right? Only realize he like to sing, right? But solo is not good at the funeral. Thank you. So we're going. What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, what peace we often forfeit. Is there trouble anywhere? We should never be discouraged. We get to the Lord in prayer. Can we find our friend so faithful? Who will all our sorrows share? Come, but with a load of care, prayer to the Lord in prayer. In his arms he'll take and shield thee. Thou wilt find thy solace there. Rest of Christ, your servant, Wilfred, with your saints. With sorrow and pain and the mourn, I sign, but life everlasting. You only are immortal, the creator and maker of mankind. And we are mortal, formed of the earth, and to earth shall we return. For so did you ordain when you created me, saying, you are dust, and to dust you shall return. All of us go down to the grave, yet even at the grave we make our song. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. The rest of Christ, your servant, Wilfred, with your saints. We saw and pain and no more, neither sign, but life everlasting. Let us commend our brother Wilfred to the mercy of God, the Maker and Redeemer. Deliver your servant, Wilfred, who suffering with Lord Christ from all evil. Set him free from every bond, that he may rest with all your saints in eternal habitation, where with the Father and the Holy Spirit you live and reign one God forever and ever. Amen. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant, Wilfred. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, sheep of your own fold, lamb of your own flock, sinner of your own redeeming. Receive him into the arms of your mercy, in the blessed rest of everlasting peace, into the glorious company of the saints in light. Amen. Gives to me will come to me. I will never turn away anyone who believes in me. He raised Jesus Christ from the dead will also give new life to his mortal bodies through his indwelling spirit. My heart therefore is glad and my spirit rejoices. My body also shall rest in hope. You will show me the path of life, and in your presence there is fullness of joy. In your right hand are pleasures forevermore. I heard a voice from heaven saying, write this, happy are the dead who die in the faith of Christ. Henceforth, says the Spirit, they may rest from their labors, for they take with them record of their deeds. Man born of a woman has but a short time to live. Like a flower, he blossoms and then withers. Like a shadow, he flees and never stays. In the midst of life, we are in debt. To whom can we turn for help but to you, Lord, who are just the younger by our sins? Lord God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, holy and most merciful Savior, deliver us from the bitter pains of death. You know the secret of our hearts. In your mercy, our prayer, forgive us all our sins, and at the last hour, let us not fall away from you. In sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life, to our Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to Almighty God our brother Wilfred Wilson, where his body will be buried at the Captive Hill Cemetery, and we commit his body to the ground to become
earth to earth.
ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. And we beseech you, the infinite goodness, to give us grace to live in your dear love and to die in your favor. When your well-beloved Son shall come again in judgment, with this, our brother Wilfred, and we ourselves will be acceptable in your sight. Thankful remembrance of your greatness, joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love. This we ask in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Rest eternal grant unto our brother Wilfred, our Lord, and let love. Let us go forth in the name of Christ. Thanks be to God. And may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of Almighty God, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, rest and remain with our brother Wilfred Wilson this afternoon, tomorrow, and forevermore. Amen. Amen. Wilfred Wilson, rest in peace and rise in glory on the resurrection day. Amen. Amen. Sin before we recess, when we all get to heaven. Sing the wondrous love of Jesus, sing his mercy and his grace. In the pleasure, bright and blessed, he prepared for us a place. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoice and of prayer. When we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory. While we walk the pilgrim pathway, clouds will overspread the sky. But when traveling days are over, not a shadow, not a sign. Oh, when we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory. Let us then be true and faithful, trusting, serving every day. Just one glimpse of him in glory will assure you. Yes, when we all get to heaven, what a day. We will sing and shout the victory. Onward to the prize before us, soon the beauty and behold. Soon the pearly gates will open, we shall tread the streets of gold. Oh, when we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory. God bless everyone gathered this afternoon.
Thank you.
Good afternoon again, everyone. So at this time, we're going to have you viewing. Please be reminded that no photos are to be taken of the deceased. Thank you.
Thank you. Hospital, Mokara Mill. You did not touch on it so far?
Huh?
Did not touch on it so far?
Left
side. Left side. Left side. Left side.
Left side. Left
side. Move the red.
Hey, what name? Remember the pull lock up this career, eh? Let's go.
I want it.
Yeah.